Everyone, today I had protein pancakes. It's been a while since I've showed you my breakfast, and since the new year has started, me and Shelby's been on a diet, so this is very low carb protein pancakes. I'm not sure what the macros are. I'm guessing for carbs max it would be around, including the peanut butter, maybe 12 grams. Protein, probably around, I don't know, 40 to 45 grams of protein in this thing. So it's a protein pack protein pancake.
Well, duh.
Also have a black coffee here. Mr. Brady's behind us, just chilling in his swing. He's loving this thing right now. Aren't you? Aren't you? Just jump around. He has been sucking his fingers like crazy lately. I hope that is not gonna be a habit. We'd rather him suck on a passy than his fingers any day. So I'm gonna sit here, enjoy this breakfast, and then we're gonna start the day. So I'm done eating, and now I want to show you exactly what I do right after I get done eating. I take my pills for the day. So I have them all laid out here in 2 weeks. So 1 week over here, 1 week over here. These are all from MuscleTech, and then whatever MuscleTech doesn't sell, I get off of bodybuilding.com, like calcium, magnesium, vitamin D, anything like that I get from bodybuilding.com series. So let me show you. So I have tons of pills here, so I just dump out one day. It's just so much easier to have one of these containers so that you don't have to pull out all these pills every single morning and stuff. So I have a fish oil here, calcium, magnesium that I was talking about, vitamin D, and then MuscleTech's multivitamin in here, and I take this right after I get done eating breakfast. And then also what I'm on right now too is MuscleTech Clear Muscle. So I take this about twice a year. I go on cycles of this stuff. So it's either when I'm on a cut trying to lose a lot of body fat, and this stuff will help maintain the muscle mass. So it's kind of like a protective shield over your muscle so you don't burn up muscle while you're in a deep cut. And then also when I'm trying to build a lot of muscle, this stuff will help you recover. And when I'm working out like right now really tough because I'm eating more calories and I'm lifting a whole lot more weight, this will help me recover and to rebuild muscle. So that's why I'm taking this. I take this stuff 3 times a day. And to talk about cycling it, I go about 12 weeks on and then maybe, I don't know, a month or two off of it, just because I don't want my body getting used to it. So for me, it's good to actually get off of it a little bit, give your body a break, and then get back on it for around 12 weeks. And not that it's gonna harm you if you go over those 12 weeks taking this stuff. It won't harm you whatsoever. It's just, like I said, I don't want my body getting used to it. And so when I do different phases, like a cutting phase, a building phase, that's when I really like to use this stuff. So today's already been a pretty productive day. So it's a new year, and so I have new contracts from bodybuilding.com, and then later on this year, like around March and stuff, I have to renegotiate all my stuff with Muscle Tech. But I just got done finalizing a lot of bodybuilding.com's new contracts. So looking forward to another year with bodybuilding.com. This will be, I guess, my sixth year with them. So it's awesome that I've been with that big of a company for that long. They have always treated me very well, so I'm very blessed there. Check out this Christmas present Shelby got me. This is probably one of the greatest gifts ever. This stuff keeps your coffee so hot. And as you guys know, I love drinking hot coffee. It's called a Yeti. I don't know if you've ever heard of that. I don't know if it's just a US thing or not, but Yeti's very big here in the US, and it keeps my coffee really hot for a long time. And then also, let me show you another gift that Shelby got me. This pretty neat bracelet here has a crown on it. I don't know if you can see that. So it's like a beaded bracelet. It came with three different ones that I've been wearing a lot of. I need to show you all the Christmas presents we got. Someone asked about that one, wanted to see all the gifts we got. I might do that later on in this video, but right now Mr. Brady is asleep. I don't want to go in there and wake him up. So yeah, I might show you that stuff later on. Now I want to go back over this contract stuff. So I'm very blessed to be doing what I love to do, which is in the fitness industry, meeting people, inspiring people, and making content for you guys. Now, the downside to that is having contracts, because in the social media world, you go by contracts every single year. So I have to renegotiate all my contracts every single year with Muscle Tech, with bodybuilding.com, everyone I've ever worked for, it's only year contracts. So when the year comes up, when your contract's coming up, you kind of are like, okay, what's gonna happen with that? Now, I'm very blessed to be growing social media-wise, so all the companies I'm working with see a value in me. So I'm not scared coming into the contracts. But years back, when I wasn't growing social media wise, every single time my contracts would come up, I would actually get scared. It's not a good feeling whatsoever. A lot of people like having that security, a 9-to-5, and they have a job where, you know, they work and work and work until they retire or they get laid off, which, you know, so no job is really secure if you really think about it. So my job is pretty much just as secure as anyone else's. It's just not knowing if your paycheck will be coming in or if you're gonna have that particular sponsorship the next year. But for me, I'm totally okay with that. But if you're one of those people that can't deal with that, then this job is not for you. And then I wanna take this time to thank you guys. You guys are the reason why I'm able to do this year after year, because the companies that I work for see a value in me because I grow, and then I have a following that actually listens to me. They actually support me. So I just wanna say again, guys, thank you so much.
1 eternity later.
So now it's around 4 o'clock, and Shelby went to the gym actually. She took a break from work, so she's taking her lunch break to actually go to the gym and knock that out. And I'm gonna go later on today. I'm gonna be going around 6 o'clock, gonna be working shoulders with a guy at the gym. He asked if I wanna work out with him, and he's a manager at Gold Gym. So I said, heck yeah. So we're gonna be working out around 6 o'clock. I'm trying to talk a little bit quieter because I do not want that kid waking up without Shelby being here. So he has a little ritual that he has to go through before he takes naps or goes to bed. So you have to swaddle him, and then you have to lay there with him, and he has to have a passy, and then you read him a story, and then you set him in his little crib. And today was actually really easy. I did it both times, and he went straight to bed. So now I'm just watching him on the monitor. I'm getting a little bit of emails done with clients and stuff. I got a lot of new clients through New Year's and stuff, so I've been working on their programs and stuff, and then we'll be going to the gym after Shelby gets back.
I think I talked a little too soon. Oh my gosh. Right when I looked at the monitor after vlogging, his eyeballs are wide open. He's not crying. He's just awake. You need another hour to an hour and a half, dude. Go back to sleep.
So I ended up jinxing Mr. Brady, because right when I got done vlogging, you saw he woke up and he did not go back to bed. So the max sleep he got was around 30 to 45 minute nap. So I'd have to go in there constantly and rock his cradle, and he would not go back to sleep. So Shelby's back, now it is 5:30, and I pretty much got nothing done in between that time because he would not sleep. So I was sitting there watching the baby monitor the whole time, and then going in there and just rocking him. Anytime I stopped rocking him, he would immediately like wake up and like look at me and like, okay, you're still here, and then like doze off a little bit, but he did not fall back completely asleep at all. So I'm going to be going to work out with this guy, like I said, the manager at Gold's Gym. I'm not sure if I'm going to be filming it because, you know, he's a manager at Gold's Gym and he knows I film, but I think it's a little bit different if I'm just handing the guy the camera and be like, here, record this for me. So we'll see. But either way, you will be seeing a shoulder workout because I recorded one maybe like 3 or 4 days ago. So you will be seeing a shoulder workout. So don't worry. So I'm going to go over there, take a pre-workout and then head to the gym. So I said I was going to take a pre-workout. No, I lied. I'm not going to take a pre-workout because it's going to be 6 o'clock before I hit the gym and I want some sleep tonight. So I'm going to take the Amino Energy, take one scoop of that. That has 100 milligrams of caffeine. And then I'm also going to take some Nano X9. This is some nitric oxide. So this is just pill form to help me get a pump and stuff. So I'm going to drink that. Then head to the gym here in about 5 minutes because I don't want to be late because it's already later than what I normally work out at. When he told me 6 o'clock at night, I was like, oh my gosh, that's just painful on a Monday night, but getting a workout partner is worth it to me, or I hope it is. We'll see how this guy works out. I've never worked out with him before. He's a built guy, so I'm hoping that it's going to be a decent workout. We'll see.
What is going on, everyone? So this shoulder workout is the pre-recorded one that I did with Shelby. I did not get to record with that guy because the gym was completely packed out. A Monday night was not a good idea to go in there and work out because I've never seen it that packed. But anyways, let's jump straight into this workout. So I started off with dumbbell shoulder press. I did 5 working sets of around 8 to 12 reps. Now, before I did my working weight, I did 3 warm-ups, and I like to warm up like the 40-pound dumbbells, the 60s, 80s, and my first working set that I stayed with was the 100-pound dumbbells. And then on the last set, this is the last set right here, so I only made it to 8 reps, and then I did a double drop set that I did not record. So what I would do is just go to complete failure, like you're seeing right now, and then immediately drop the weight. I would drop the weight by 30 pounds this first drop. So I went from the hundreds to the 70s, and then from the 70s to the 55s, and then just went to failure in every single one of those. After that, went into a superset here. I did dumbbell side raises, 5 sets of these as well. So for 12 to 15 reps. And then as you can see, I'm keeping the dumbbells in front of me a little bit and then going out to the side. Doing those for those 12 to 15 reps, superset with barbell behind the head press. This gets a very bad rep. A lot of people don't like this exercise. I think it's completely fine if you don't go below the ear and if you have good shoulder mobility. Now, if you don't and if this hurts you, don't do this. Just do this to the front of you. That's completely fine. So I did another 12 reps on here. So there's 5 sets of 12 reps. As you can see, I'm going slow. I'm doing slow reps, just trying to get that mind-muscle connection. So I'm not trying to sling the weight up or anything. So I'm going very slow reps and stuff, trying to get that time under tension. After that, went into another superset. It was a shoulder press on the leg press superset with plate front raises. Now I did 5 sets of these for around 8 to 12 reps. So each time I would go about 12 reps, I would just add a little bit more weight, and then I ended about 8 reps. So I went for those reps with the leg press and then went straight into plate front raises, or these can be called bus drivers, because what you're doing, you're going up and you're going to one side then the other side, so you're twisting it up at the top. And I did right at like 12 reps, so 6 on each side with the twisting, and then went into a leaning cable side raise. I did not superset this with anything, it was just straight set. So I would do right around like 12 reps on each arm. So I would do, let's say, the right arm, then the left arm, and then I would only rest for around 30 seconds in between those arms. Now, the rest of the workout, after doing like the supersets and stuff, I was resting for about 1 minute in between sets, but this particular exercise, I only rested about 30 seconds after I got done with both arms. Now, after doing these straight sets, went into another superset, but we moved on to rear delts now. So I did a rear delt fly with the cables. I did 4 sets of these for around 12 to 15 reps, superset with rope face pulls. So on here, what you're trying to do, I have the cables not all the way up, but just above head height level. So I'm going back, squeezing my rear delts as much as possible, keeping time under tension, and then immediately after doing all those reps, going to failure, went into the kneeling rope face pull. So here I'm trying to pull apart the rope. So pull it apart when I pull back, and I'm trying to pull it right above like my forehead height. And I like to do where the cable is just above head height on there. And then moving on to the last exercise, it was a kettlebell shrug. I did four sets of around 12 to 15 reps, pausing up at the top just for like a split second, trying to get that mind muscle connection and just squeezing. Now, if you don't have kettlebells in your gym, you can use dumbbells. That is completely fine. All right, guys, that's the end of the workout. I hope you enjoyed the rest of the video. Thank you so much for watching. So I'm back home from that workout. As you can see, I did not get to film with that guy. The gym was absolutely packed. I've never seen the gym this packed ever. I could not find a parking spot to start off when I was getting there. Brady's has an attitude right now. He needs to go to bed, but Shelby's trying to keep him up until 9 o'clock. Right now it's 8:30. And so anyways, the gym was completely packed, so I did not film that workout. It was a great one. We worked out for basically 2 hours. It was a long workout, but when you have a workout partner, it takes a whole lot longer, and then you push each other, so you do more sets and reps and all that stuff. So now I'm back home and we are eating some chili. Shelby made some homemade chili there with some turkey meat and stuff. So healthy chili, have a Diet Pepsi right here. So we're gonna sit here, watch some TV, and enjoy this meal. So now it is 11:30 and Shelby's already in the bed and Mr. Brady is asleep. That's why I'm being really quiet here. So I know today's video is not that long. It does have a workout in it and I did do a little bit of vlogging, but I'm gonna tie in tomorrow into today's video. So I'm gonna see y'all tomorrow. Well, hello everyone. I would say good morning, but it is afternoon. I have not vlogged all day long. It is 5:15. So her mom came by to watch Mr. Brady while we got work done today. So I've been editing videos all day and Shelby's been working. Then I went to New Fit today and worked some legs. But I wanted to show you exactly what I got for Christmas. And I'm not gonna show you everything because, you know, I got little odds and ends stuff, but I'm gonna show you the main gifts. So first off, I showed you this bracelet already. This is one of three bracelets Shelby got me. It's from a company off Instagram I saw a while back. And they had like a Black Friday sale. So I told Shelby that I wanted some bracelets like this. So she got me this one. And then I have like a band bracelet right here that has like different designs on it. And then another beaded bracelet that you can adjust the size on. So those three from that same company. Then what else? And then I got two watches, Versace watches. I have a gold, like a rose gold watch here. Let me see if you can see that. Yeah, rose gold with blue and gray. The band, the leather band is gray. And then have one the exact same thing, but a different color. So this is a silver and a gray band as well, but the whole thing is silver. So I got both those watches from Shelby. And then my sister, we draw names every year, so my older sister got me this year, so she got me some Converse. When I was Black Friday shopping, I was gonna buy these, but they were out of my size, so she knew exactly what I wanted, so she went back, and they actually had my size, so she bought these. These are waterproof Converse boots. I love the color. This goes well with my khaki pants and stuff, so I got these. And then she got me a Patriots apron. See the picture right there? So it's a Patriots apron that I'll be wearing when I cook and stuff. And then my brothers got me Red Dead 2, so I'll be playing that later on. Right now I'm not playing that that much at all because it's still in beta mode is what it's called, so it's not much to do on this game right now, multiplayer. And that's the only reason why I play video games at all is multiplayer, so I can play with my brothers. But until they start adding more stuff to it, I'm not really playing that much of Red Dead. I'm still playing Rainbow Six a whole lot. What else did I get? Oh, I got some more hoodies. Shelby got me the green one, and then her mother got me this maroon one. This one is a really cool color, and this is going with all my green that I've been really into lately. So the green Adidas and this one. So I have, I guess, three Adidas hoodies now. And then speaking of Adidas, Shelby also got me this shirt with a white one, exactly the same. It's just completely white over here with the exact same logo and stuff. And then Shelby got me another hoodie. It's a Champion hoodie, gray color. And then she also got me an Adidas long sleeve shirt here, black.
with the white stripes going down it in the back. And then she got me Adidas hat. She got me all kinds of Adidas stuff. And I believe that is it. I'm not gonna show you everything that Brady got because he got so many clothes. He got like wardrobes for like years. He's probably never gonna wear half the stuff because he's gonna grow so quickly. But that's gonna be the end of the video, guys. I just wanted to show you exactly what I got, like I said I was going to do. So if you have any suggestions on what you wanna see in these videos, just comment them down below because I would love to get content that you guys want to see. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, give it a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see y'all next time. All right, guys, peace.
Hey, buddy, Brady, hey, buddy, hey, hey, yes.